Hello and welcome to this quick conversation. Today I'm joined by the excellent Daniel, who is an educator from India. In fact, Daniel, could you introduce yourself briefly for us?
Hi, Jacob. Thank you for having me. I am Daniel Sundaram from Bangalore, India, and I teach in a school. I teach geography and percussion currently, but I also help out with all the tech integration that happens in the school and in the classroom. We've been using the iPads in our school for about 10 years now, and we've seen growth and the way it's impacted the students and their learning and their interactions has been lovely. I also help out with doing a few Apple professional learning sessions within our school and outside of it.
Excellent. Thank you for that. So before we started recording, we were having a really interesting conversation that I'm hoping we can carry on into this format, about how you use the keyboards on devices to help students acquire language skills. Could you just, in a nutshell, explain what we mean? Because some people watching this will think, well, I type on my keyboard, what else can it do? But there's a lot more to it, isn't there?
Absolutely. Yes, so for those of you listening, the keyboard is, in this case, on the iPad. The students are using them as a virtual keyboard. And so the fact that it's not fixed, meaning you can manually move it around and split it. But apart from that, the fact that you could change language on these keyboards, and by that I mean you could change it into, for in our context, we could do Kannada, which is our local language. We could do Hindi, and we have a list of other Indian languages, which means, again, you're doing two things that are available. You have transliteration, wherein you're just typing out in English and the words are translating into that particular language, or you have the option of also typing out in that particular native language and it just magically appears on your screen.
So because the keyboard is a software tool, there are lots and lots of different variations depending on what region you're in and what language you want to type in. Let's have a very quick look actually how you can enable it on your device, and then we'll come back and carry on this conversation. You can change the available keyboards on iPad by going to the Settings app and under General going on to Keyboards. Then at the top of the screen you're going to tap Keyboards again, and here you can select any keyboards you want to include. I've already got the emoji keyboard and the French keyboard installed, but I'm just going to choose a couple of Chinese ones as well to demonstrate the difference between them. When you've chosen the keyboards you want, you can then go back into whatever app you are using, and on the keyboard in the bottom left corner you tap and hold that globe icon. This will bring up a floating menu of the different keyboards, and simply by tapping onto one of those, your keyboard will change to mirror whatever you've just selected. This means the keyboard layout will change, the actual symbols and glyphs on the keyboard will change as well, even spell check in the document will become native to the language you're currently typing in.
Okay, so you've seen how easy it is to actually have multiple devices. In my demo, I added the French keyboard and the Chinese keyboard, which is a slightly random selection of keyboards, to be fair. But can you explain how your students use this and the impact that has on their learning?
Indeed. So I'm going to first talk about this one student who sort of came up with a degenerative vision problem, right? And then here, when it came to language acquisition, he couldn't really see everything very clearly. So to start with, just the accessibility features that it provides were amazing. But in addition to that, learning English as a second language for some, whereas a few other students who came in and were not really very fluent with English and preferred to use their native language, mm-hmm. had immediately this option to switch over to their own native keyboard and then type out information in text, have it read back to them, and which meant that the discussion and the learning and the acquisition of language, especially in speaking and in typing, became a lot more fast. Now, this was something that we didn't necessarily plan, and it was just a feature that we suddenly discovered and happened upon, and it worked marvelously. And the students could not only see academic improvement, but also an improvement when it came to their emotional connect, especially some of the students in our school being from diverse socioeconomic and cultural backgrounds. We found this a very useful tool to get them to engage and learn those languages.
I mean, in terms of inclusion alone, the fact that the students can type in their native language, it breaks down that barrier from a lesson being taught in a specific language, because suddenly the students can
can complete their learning in the language that suits them best. You also mentioned translate there as well. Is there an element of the students or the staff translating between the languages?
Oh, yes. So in fact, the two options that the keyboard feature allows, which is one being transliteration and the other being you typing out in your local language. Now, what I also forgot to mention is not only the interaction among students, but also the interaction from teacher to student and student to teacher. So okay. That also so a marked difference. Now, so there are instances wherein communication, especially when it comes from student to student, because of the lack of a particular knowledge of a particular language, the transliteration feature really helped them express. Combine that with the Translate app, also that is available, and suddenly the students, their vocabulary really enhanced and they were able to communicate seamlessly. This, we particularly see this growth towards the latter end of the primary years, so from standard 4-5, when they get a little adept at using this technology, which is so intuitive to use, and carries on through middle school. And by then, we also notice a shift, like I said, in their interaction on a cultural level, on a human level, so to speak, even just because of the diverse backgrounds that they come from. Initially, they don't seem to mix and mingle, just for the lack of commonality, so to speak. And I can put this on record and go ahead and say that this was one tool that actually helped them bring themselves as a group, as a cohort, as a group of students and learners together in that classroom.
It's so powerful hearing you talk about that, and the way your face lights up as you talk about it, I can tell how much it means to you and your students, and it's a wonderful story to hear, so thank you. I'm here thinking about this, and I'm wondering if there are barriers in terms of if the students are using their native language, is there the risk that you're not able to then, you know, teach them the language that you need them to learn as well? Is there a way you can use both? How does that work in the classroom?
Well, yes, I'm glad you asked that question. So as part of the learning, while we do have three languages that we've got to learn, ideally as a student in the Indian curriculum, usually based on where we are, it's English as a first language that's being taught. You have Kannada now, which is a mandatory second language that has to be taught. And then third language, the national language, Hindi. Now, families move and travel across. And when they come to our state, they're kind of forced in to pick up Kannada at whichever grade or class level they're joining any private school in Bangalore or Karnataka. And that makes it difficult for them to suddenly acquire this language. So in this case, being able to, of course, type and write in English and read in English, but also the fact that the iPad provides the option of not just typing out, but also having text read back to you in language that is native to you. You can also select the text and translate it to another language just on that one single document right in front of you. Makes it so much more easier to use for the student and for the teacher, so much so that you have your English translation, you can have your Kannada translation, you can have your Hindi translation, all three in one page. And of course, the added features of looking up meanings, having it read back to you in different accents, I think makes learning a joy and a pleasure for these students. And for those of them like me who can't read in a moving bus or train or while traveling back, plug in your earphones and you can listen to the text being read out to you in English, in Kannada, and Hindi, and then just makes language acquisition so much more easier.
And it's something which just wouldn't have been possible 10 or 15 years ago before we had devices on the tables in classrooms like this. You know, having the ability to translate between three different languages in real time, in written text and in audio. It's phenomenal when you think about how far technology has come, isn't it? It's amazing to think about how that technology, how that, you know, computer in front of you has such a profound impact on the lives of those students.
Absolutely. And so I should add, one of the students actually gave us this idea and went ahead and is actually in the process right now making this little book wherein they've got the English alphabet, when you got A for apple, for example. And then they got a similar thing in Kannada and in Hindi that says R4. And it's also pictorial, right? So we've got the visual cue of what the letter looks like, the word looks like, and you're hearing what is being pronounced like because you have the feature of recording yourself so easily onto it. And so you got the alphabet, you got the image, you got the pronunciation that speaks back to you. And so they're working on a keynote that they're putting together for the two classes junior or for anyone who comes in and has a language acquisition problem.
Wow. I would love to see that when it's finished, if it's able to be shared. I think we're going to post these quick conversations in the Apple education community. So I wonder if that's a resource that might pop up there in the future as well. I'll be keeping an eye out.
Yes, yes. And meeting this community of AD learners online and interacting with them has given us so much more ideas. And I'm absolutely looking forward to share this book once it's ready with the community.
Daniel, thank you so much for your time today. It's been really insightful hearing how you're using the keyboards with your students and the impact that's having on them, not just as learners, but as human beings growing up into the world. So thank you so much for your time and sharing that wisdom with people watching today.
Thank you for having me on this call, Jake. I'm happy to share these experiences.